Hello, and welcome back to Chattery Included, where today, I'm going to teach you how to draw a jellyfish. Step 1. Start with a circle for the head and two smaller circles for the eyes. Step 2. Shape the head using smooth, curvy lines. Step 3. Add a series of small circles. These will serve as the base for the tentacles or arms. Step 4. Use curvy lines to shape the tentacles, paying attention to where they connect to the head. Step 5. Refine your drawing by cleaning up any lines you don't need. Fill in the facial features, adding details as you go. And there you have a jellyfish. Step 6 would be to run out of breath from talking like that, because it's actually kind of taxing on my breathing pattern. That would be a really boring video if that was all it is. So, while I scrap this jellyfish, I'm going to draw a jellyfish mermaid. So, you remember how I said one of my New Year's resolutions was to draw with more backgrounds and, like, work on those? Well, it turns out, when you're drawing something from deep sea, there's not a lot of background that can be done. So, we're not doing a background for this one. We're gonna abandon our resolution very quickly into January. At least for this particular piece. I don't know, maybe I'll compare next year, like the amount of backgrounds I did to the amount of backgrounds I do this year. We'll see. But for now, jellyfish mermaid. So I started this a while ago. I think I did the base sketch in December, but it's one of those things where I thought I was never going to come back to it, so I put it down. And then, to my own surprise, I really wanted to continue it, so when I saw it this week, I thought this would be good practice in not finishing art in one sitting. It's going to be a tough habit to break, but maybe I can give it a shot. At least a couple pieces throughout the year. Why the heck not? There are a couple spots where it's pretty noticeable that I put it down, or that I stepped away for a little while and forgot to hit pause in the recording. So I actually continued this in 3 separate sittings. The first sitting being back in December for the base sketch, the second being the more refined sketch, and then that attempt at coloring, which didn't go well. I don't know when that'll pop up, but you'll see I just like colored the face and then tried to do some noses. I just weren't feeling them, so I decided to go back to the typical line art style that I do. And the third sitting, I think, is during the coloring process, because I started having to stop and pull up references and step away for a bit to handle things and not let myself get too tired of it. I kind of want to do a real how to draw a jellyfish tutorial, but I feel like jellyfish are one of those things that people already have tutorials out for. Like, I know I've definitely seen them with, like, markers and pens. I don't know about digitally, but I've definitely seen them with markers and pens. I'm pretty sure I've seen one on like TikTok. But as for the jellyfish tutorial I did at the beginning, this is a I Draw Sea Life beginner book from the dollar store that I pulled the pictures from, and I read the instructions to you word for word as they are on the page. 5-step jellyfish, which mine turned out to be nightmare fool. Theirs isn't much better in my opinion. Like, this face will haunt me for the rest of my days. Some of the other creatures in here are much better, but I wanted to do the jellyfish and I figured this would be fun either way. Maybe if you guys enjoyed this video, I will do another one with like the octopus or the dolphin. The sea turtle is actually really cute, honestly. The shark doesn't read shark, but there's a lot of sea life in here. Well, I say there's a lot, let me see. There are 10 things in here. So like maybe I can go back and do another one at some point. Maybe for mermaid, I'll do this again. The same formula for the video of showing you the how to draw book and then drawing a mermaid from it. That's if I even participate in mermaid. I don't know if I will this year. Last year was fun, don't get me wrong, but kind of spice things up. So initially for this picture, I was going to do way more of like the wispy tendril strings tentacles. Are they considered tentacles? As you can see, I don't like doing research into what I'm drawing, because I did not look up jellyfish anatomy to tell you what the word for that is. I could do better. Do better. Be better than me going forward. So yeah, I was initially going to do more of the wispy stringy tentacles on the tail to kind of like tie it all together, and then I was going to do some of the hair, but I lost focus in that. And I don't know if anyone else has picked up on this watching the videos, but I go back and watch them when I'm editing them together, and I'll notice so many details in my initial sketch that by the end of my process I have completely forgotten about. And usually it's just because I'm tired and I didn't line it, or it just fell away in the bigger picture and my eyes weren't picking up on it anymore, and by the end of it I'm like, oh, I forgot something. But in this one, since I did it in like 3 different sittings, I had plenty of time to like consciously make the decision of, no, it's going to be really, really busy anyways with the tendrils, and the point of the mermaid is to kind of fall into the background. It's, you're supposed to look at the picture and see jellyfish, and then stare at the picture and see mermaid. Like, oh, like a little surprise, a little treat. Also, I think I remember hearing somewhere that jellyfish are just floating nervous systems, and that could totally be from Game Grumps, but it could have also been something like David Attenborough said on a nature documentary. Either way, due to the fact that I'm pretty sure jellyfish are just floating nervous systems, I tried to make her face not so placid, but bro, I was lazy with it. I'll be honest, I knew most of it was going to be covered up anyway, so I didn't spend a lot of time on like imperfections in the hand, or like the weird width of the chest and the way that the neck doesn't line up right. Like, I wasn't worried with it. I knew most of it was going to be covered up because I wanted to read jellyfish. And then like in parentheses in a much smaller font. So, how do you think I did? Which jellyfish do you prefer? My jellyfish or the How to Draw a Book jellyfish? I'll be honest, Nightmare Fuel is kind of one of my jams. I do like the spooky things, so maybe I like the I Draw Sea Life beginner book jellyfish more. Let me know what you think in the comments below. It was fun chatting with you today. I had a lot of fun doing this mermaid. I even had fun doing the How to Draw book jellyfish. It was kind of cutesy and weirdly refreshing, even if mine turned out a little wonky. Feel free to comment, like, subscribe, all that jazz to join us in the next one. And I hope to see you guys again soon. Bye-bye!